the suspects were equipped with handcuffs and gasoline and grabbed 16-year-old Palestinian Mohammed Abu Khedair after they had tried and failed to kidnap an 8-year-old boy. Three young Israelis, all related, were seeking revenge for the kidnapping and murders of three Israeli teenagers. A new report from Israel's Internal Security Service says on July 2nd, quote, "For several hours, the kidnappers patrolled Jerusalem Arab neighborhoods trying to find a victim, until they found Mohammed Abu Khedair." The three Israeli suspects grabbed Khedair by force, as shown in this surveillance video, took him to a nearby forest, then bludgeoned and burned him to death, according to the report. Israeli officials say the suspects, who've not been named, admitted to the killing and reenacted it.
The three Israelis who have been accused of this have a long history of violence. One of them has been declaring legal insanity.
Analysts say that incident and the killing of the three Israeli teenagers by Palestinian suspects led to this escalation and the brink of a wider war between Israel and Hamas. But the murder of the young Palestinian has also sparked a moral debate inside Israel.
After the killing of Mohammed Abu Khedair, there's been a tremendous rise of introspection and debate within Israeli society and in the Israeli media.
Social media fuels the concerns. Anti-Arab tweets from Israelis are plentiful. This apparent Facebook posting after the three Israeli teenagers were murdered shows two girls holding up a sign saying in Hebrew, "Hating Arabs is not racism, it's values. Israel demands revenge." Analysts say this does not reflect mainstream Israeli views, and they don't detect a widespread rise in Jewish extremism. But they say the two groups are increasingly isolated from each other.
Over the years, fewer and fewer Israelis and Palestinians actually work and live together. Even when they appear to be side by side, when you visit a beach, for example, in Israel, you'll see Palestinians and Israelis, but they pass each other by without talking.
Now, among extreme factions, it of course cuts both ways. There are Arabs, like those in Hamas, who won't even recognize Israel. But one analyst points out, polls often show the majority of Israelis and Palestinians want to get along and realize they're going to have to continue living side by side.